boys have been the boys. As you all know, Arabs are always late. The plane boards at like 11:45, so they're gonna make it with like 5 minutes. But knowing the boys, they'll probably do 200s in Brisbane.
Psych!
Okay, ask the captain, are we on Hamilton Island?
This guy, who
else? No way!
We're going straight to the crib now. As you guys know, we're in Hamilton Island for the weekend. It's going to be a great day. Can't wait for it.
Today we're going to be going jet skiing. It's going to be a fun day. We've got a private tour here. So that's going to be happening. This big thing's coming. You guys are not ready for this. So let's go.
Pop that. See, we got organic broccoli, healthy cheese.
That's cheese. Cheese.
A lot of cheese.
Love cheese or what?
I love cheese, man.
Right now, he's got his hands up. What do I have to do? Protect myself. I have to have my hands up at all costs, right? So for example now, if I'm not protecting myself, here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna hit, I drop my guard, he's hitting me, right? You need to make sure that this is here and your chin is at the bottom of here. So when someone goes for the hook, they're not jabbing you from the jaw, right? And they're not hooking you by the jaw. Where they're hooking you is here, so it's a lot less damage. And at the same time, your hand there is to protect you. Your hand there is to keep you defended. Don't worry about the person. Let him run out of stamina and you can do whatever the fuck you want. But at the start, you need to learn defense is first. Then comes your agility with the jabs and the hooks and everything. Tire the person out, get the person with the momentum happening. That's what boxers do. They get the momentum going, let the person tire out, and guess what? From there, boom, knockout. Why? The person's out of breath. You can do whatever the fuck you want. The person's not functioning anymore. Stamina is key here. Defense as well. Defense, stamina, very, very important.
It's pretty tired. Just trained a lot. Worked a lot. It's all about, you know, building the momentum, alright? So the day comes, the day goes. Either you run the day or the day runs you.
Alright, so guys, whole time it was Vion's birthday today. None of us even said happy birthday to that guy, and he probably feels forgotten. But that's never the case with the 1%. We always take care of our brothers. So Abdullah and Hakim decided to devise a crazy prank, right? So basically we're gonna blindfold Vion. We're gonna surprise him with the crazy ass hotel, super luxury hotel, but whole time. It's a shitty ass one. So we sorted out a crazy cake from Woolies. We got candles ready, all that. He's gonna go inside the house. He's gonna have a look around. He's gonna think, what the fuck is this? As soon as he comes back out, all the boys are gonna be out there and they're gonna wish him a happy birthday.
And open it.
Is this my room?
Yeah.
Oh, bro. Oh, I made it finally.
This is living, baby.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to you.
Look, I had to come up with shit on the spot. And part of being creative, you've got to come up with shit on the spot, alright? So,
yeah, it's just fun. No.
We got him a place. I mean, it looks great. All right, he's got a roof over his head. That's what you got to talk about.
He's better than being homeless.
And we couldn't get him the right number, so we got him 40. And we're going to keep that until he's 40, so we use it again.
Good morning, good morning.
Good morning, good morning. Good day, big day.
Home time, home time.
Yes.
make it live. What's going on? Wakey, wakey, what's your thoughts, Vian? What are your thoughts?
What's the task?
My thoughts are for every African on time, there's two Arabs that are late.
Oh, there you go.
Every what?
Every on time. So, as always, we're always on time. We definitely didn't miss the ferry or our flight or had to reschedule to a different airport. So, we're definitely not doing that, but we are doing that. So yeah, we getting a taxi, going to a different airport.
It is what it is. So that's why it's important to always be on time, because time is money. And yeah, as we can say, but look, live and learn. It is what it is.
You know, even if you're wealthy or, you know, you're successful, you've got money and whatever, if you're never busy, like, feel like your life is boring, right? You gotta have things going on, you gotta have things happening, and it's just another day. We've got things happening, meetings going on, projects happening, building, whatever, right? We've got things going on, and that's important to have, and we're capable of that. It's quite hard to say that when you're, you know, only 23, but I'm able to say that because I've had the discipline, you know, from a very young age, and I'm proud, I'm grateful. And at the same time, this is such a positive energy to the people, right? Because what do you see? Right now, you get to see the day in the life, you get to see what we do, you get to see the energy we bring into these day in the life vlogs, and, you know, I would have to say that it should be really appreciated because it inspires you, right? And for the people that don't like it, for the people that obviously it's not something that they want to see, then those are the people that are quite, you know, closed-minded. They don't want to see something that they could be inspired from and learn from. But what they'll do instead is they'll hate on it and then be nobodies for the rest of their life. And that's totally up to you. We're here to, you know, change the game in many ways. And you can listen to a 36-year-old, but when a 23-year-old's talking about these things, it's like a different story, right? Like, how the fuck do you do it at a young age, right? How the fuck are you able to live such a life at a very, very young age? And I genuinely feel like if you desire a lifestyle, right, and that lifestyle is something that you're wanting to obviously live for the rest of your life, I genuinely think you can do it. If you actually want to live broke, you're going to live broke. If you want to live rich, you're going to one day live rich. And God loves the people that work. God loves the slave that actually wakes up, works, you know. And as men, as I've said before, you're going to go through hardships. As a man, you're going to go through difficulties in your life. As a man, you're meant to go through that, right? And if you don't want to go through that, then you should have been a girl. Okay? You were born that way. You've got to accept it. And you've got to move with it. And what are we doing here? We've been through hardships. We've been through, I mean, the whole group has. Hakam's been through a lot. Same with Garashi. You know, people that I'm very close with. But we don't mind. We'll lose all the money we have and we'll go, you know, we'll go live by the beach. We'll start from point blank. But guess what we're going to do? We're going to stand the fuck up again. And we're going to get up. We're going to work hard. We're going to start pushing each other again and again and again. And that's life. We just got to accept it. I just hate the people that are like negative, you know, like a problem happens, something's going on in their life, and next minute it's just, look, I've given up. I don't know how people do that, right? And I actually look, if there's one thing, if God right now asked me for one favor, I mean, one wish, God asked me for one wish right now to make, it'd be to never sleep again. Because if I never slept, I wouldn't be a millionaire right now, I'd be a billionaire. I feel like sleeping's a waste of time, let alone we have people who go to sleep, wake up broke. How the fuck do you do that? Doesn't make sense, you know, like, if I'm sorry to say, but if you're living broke and you're not working to obviously change your life, you're absolutely fucked. Okay, you could be the person that works at KFC, goes back home, right, does a bit of work, I don't know, on the side, some bullshit, whatever it is, play video games and go to sleep, and what happens after, right? You're gonna be a nobody for the rest of your existence. But if you want to leave a legacy, or at some stage, right, have a responsibility over your life where you can control it in many ways, you have to have wealth. Wealth is power, right? But don't regard wealth as success, because wealth doesn't necessarily mean you're successful. You have to have the balance in your life. A lot of people that are wealthy, they end up being depressed. A lot of people that are wealthy, they end up completely losing all their network, losing their friends, losing their families, losing, because they don't have a balance. You have to have a balance in life, okay? Even if you're rich, you know, it doesn't mean you get to be fat. No. Being rich, right, and being, you know, being wealthy, the best part about it is when you actually have a balance in the background, right? When you're fit, you know, you've got a great mindset. You know, you've outworked yourself. You work, like, you know what a flex is these days? A crazy flex, I would say, is when you're successful and you've got money and whatever, and you could do whatever the fuck you want, but you outwork everyone every day. Like, who the fuck does that? Everyone that gets rich gets comfortable. Everyone that gets rich, like, they become lazy. The people that are rich and the people that are wealthy and the people that could do whatever the fuck they want, like me, right? We outwork everyone. Put me in any fucking environment now and I'll outwork anyone. Anyone. Why? Because I'm just used to it. And that's why I talk about balance. Balance is important because you have that in your life. Even though you're rich, you're never comfortable. You're just grinding towards it. That's a lost cause. High stakes, body armor, suicide, boy. This is time for games and it's the time to kill. Make up your mind, baby, cause the time is here. How the fuck then they have supercars on the island? Going 2 days without hearing a noise like this goes crazy. Just love, you love that, you know, that noise. Just cause, you know, I'm all about cars and cause obviously I'm Arab and I love my cars. I love my V8, I love my V10s. V16 very soon. Hey, what's up, boys?
Hey, what's up, man? Look, when the black car is in the white car. Wanna race or what?
That car's in steroid.
This top G.
Top of the range. We don't drive G's, we drive Breeze. Driver's in.
Top G, let's race. Got it. Right.
Hey.
Got it. Let's go! Fuck.
My own car just beat me. Swap for right now. That car's staged, so it's very, very quick. Murder on my mind, it's time to pray to God.
My revolver's not religious, the revolution's born. All right, let's go. Here we go.
I'm not losing.
I don't lose either, man. I don't lose either.
Hesta.
Huh?
You had a
Hesta. I didn't have a Hesta. I can do it again. I didn't, right? I still win anyway, bro. This is a beast, bro.
Man, this thing's too thick.
This is a beast, bro. Yeah. Don't race me, cuz.
Killers everywhere. It ain't no place to run. Let it go. 1 a.m. Babs are the options. Let's send it. Ain't no mercy. Ain't no mercy.